You probably already know there's a lot of benefit to boosting posts on Facebook. But if you know this, you also know that there's some decisions you have to make when doing so. And did you know that there's even more decisions to make when buying an ad versus boosting a post? Like, honestly, what is the difference there anyway? So many questions, Facebook. Today we're gonna talk about how to use Facebook ads and boosted posts to target your audience. I'm Sammy, and here at Digivangelism, we make videos every single Tuesday morning at 9 a.m. Eastern Time. We do this to help progressive leaders of spiritual communities share hope, healing, and light better and better online, which Facebook obviously helps you do. If that kind of information sounds interesting to you, please subscribe below so you don't miss a single video that we put out each and every week. With no further ado, let's get started. So as I alluded to before, boosting a post does have less options available to you than buying an ad for your post. This means when you're buying an ad, you can be more focused in your targeting of who you want this ad to reach. Now obviously this is a great benefit to you as a social media manager, but it also makes it a little more complicated. If you don't want to get into all the details, you can just boost a post and still get reach without targeting exactly who you want it to get to. First things first, with either of these options, you need to establish your goals before you boost or buy. While traditional business marketing is focused really on sales, a lot of digital ministry is focused on reach and engagement. You might choose to boost a post just to encourage a lot more people with your inspiring thought, to make sure that especially inspiring message gets to even more eyes and ears. You're increasing your reach because you want to increase your impact with this message. If you have an event that you really want people to attend, you might want to be a little more aggressive and actually boost an ad targeting specific people. So is your goal just to inspire people to get your post in front of more and more people? Or are you actually hoping a very specific set of people will attend a specific event or do something, take some kind of action? Establish your goal ahead of time. Second, decide on your budget. Thankfully, Facebook ads lets you set and control a budget, so you're not going to be charged more than what you decide. The more budget that you have available, the more impact this ad or boosted post could make. You can send it out to even more people in a short amount of time, or make it run for even more days. Thankfully, you don't have to spend much money at all for Facebook to help you out and get your posts in front of more and more eyes. Don't be afraid to drop some money on this and try different options out. You're going to try and fail a couple different times as you do this over the next few months and years. Things are always changing, and there's no perfect setting that you can put on your post to make it get in front of the perfect audience. So do your best and don't push yourself out of your budget. Third, decide on your call to action. What is your goal with this post? We talked about that in step one. Okay, now connect it to a call to action for your post. You're spending money on this, so you want to make sure people actually do something with it, right? Make sure it is just one definitive call to action. We can get really confused when there are multiple things that we're being asked to do, so just keep it simple for your people. Sign up for an event. Subscribe to an email list. Make a donation for a special cause. Make it clear. Keep it obvious. Step four, just get out there and do this. It's so easy to watch video after video and try to make it perfect, but like we said, there is no perfect setting. Do your best to target your people, make your post clear, and learn as you do this. It's no secret that organic reach is getting harder and harder on Facebook. It wants you to buy ads. It wants you to boost posts. And so if you want to share hope, healing, and light online, we have to get better and better at this. We have to at least try. So determine your goals, set your budget, create your call to action, and just get out there and do it. So we know this was a really, really basic overview today. Now, keeping in mind that there's no perfect setting for your boosted posts or your ads, what questions do you have? Please drop them below, and we'd love to follow up with another video explaining even more. I'm Sammy, I'm here with Digivangelism every single Tuesday morning. If this video was at all helpful for you, please be sure to subscribe below, because we keep putting them out every week. Like it, tell a friend. That was more than one call to action. Today we brought some knowledge, it's your turn to put it into action. Peace.